This is my primary vehicle of transportation. It's small, but pretty darn fast. Faster than this car. It's nimble, and I can go around pretty tight corners easily. I've had this for 2.5 years. Up close, this is what it looks like. Pretty dirty and beat up. Some days ago, I lost this bolt, so I just took one I had lying around. It doesn't actually go all the way through, but it looks okay, I think. I've lost some nuts underneath during the years, so some of the nuts are of different sizes, which means I can't use the same tool for all of them. I'm using some penny board trucks and wheels, which is one of the best trucks I've used. Also, I have my name and phone number in case I lose it, but I've taped it over for this video. Sorry, I don't want you calling. There is more thought put into this than meets the eye though. The wheels are placed at a 90 degree angle from the edges of the board, both on the front and on the sides. This is what allows it to be able to stand upright and on the side. It also means the width of the board is 15.3 centimeters, the same as the trucks and wheels. It's 40 centimeters long, which is about enough for me to be able to have both feet on the board when riding, even though I usually only have one foot on, while kicking the board forward constantly with the other. A side effect of placing the wheels in line with the board edges is that the center of the truck is further out, meaning I can lean more forwards without the board tipping over. I also opted to not have grip tape, since after going on a test ride, I decided I didn't need it. The reason why I bring all these specific things up is that this isn't my first plank skateboard. This is. I made it in September of 2019. For funsies, I put some stickers and some reflective tape on it. But it's not really reflective. From version 1, I learned some important lessons. If you compare it to my new board, it was a bit too small to stand upright. Now back to my current board. It looks pretty rough, so I bought some new bolts and nuts. They are completely black though, so I decided to paint them white like my current bolts on the board. While waiting for the bolts to dry, I also decided to clean up the board and trucks. This was a bit of a hassle since I had three types of bolts. One that wasn't even fastened, using a pointy thing to get it out. One using skateboard size nuts, which I can use the skate tool for. And one with ordinary nuts, which I used a super cute tiny little wrench for. I first used a wet scrap cloth towel to clean with, but it didn't really do anything. I then switched to using a brass brush, but honestly, it just looks like I smudged out the dirt and dust. Not really sure what to do, I went haywire and brushed up the rest of the board too. To be honest, it didn't really make that much of a difference, but I think it elevated the striped effect on the board, which is a little bit cool. I didn't do too much with the trucks, since they are permanently damaged from debris and always look dirty. With that said, it was pretty satisfying to clean the bearings. It was at this point I realized that my old bolts were a bit longer than the new ones, and I knew that my current bolts already were on the short side. A bit short-sighted by me, so I opted to use the old ones. The plan is to put in the screws first, then flip the board and put on the trucks. Until I remembered I had lost one of the bolts entirely. So I guess I had to use one of the new bolts anyways. Right now I'm editing, and during this part where I'm screwing in the nuts, there isn't really much to say, but I don't want to cut it out since I think it looks pretty cool to have such a close-up. I'm screwing them on by hand, and I'll tighten them later. However, the new bolt was too short. I thought that I could sort of push it in a bit, but it was useless. I couldn't tighten it and it would fall out, so I couldn't even have it for nice looks. The paint hadn't dried completely either, so I also got some of it on my tool and fingers. Dang it. If only there was something I could use which would fill in this empty hole. Wait, is that the old bolt? Ah, perfection. And that pretty much sums it up. I don't have a car and I haven't had a bicycle since mine got stolen in high school. I've only used skateboards since then, and this is my absolute favorite. It's small, and I can take it about anywhere. I can even go faster than some on bikes. It can act as a footrest, an improvised chair, as whatever. And the absolute best thing is that it just looks like a freaking plank. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I had making it. Leave a like, and do subscribe for more jank stuff. Okay, that's probably it then. I'm going to talk for a little while here still, so I can get these YouTube annotations visible. Check out this video which YouTube thinks you like. Item. See ya!